here's how to make your own melatonin instead of needing to take melatonin supplements to help you sleep. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about what you need to make your own melatonin. So number one, you need to get tryptophan into the brain. I've talked about this in several episodes before. That means having at least one meal in the day where you have a high amount of carbohydrate, preferably a higher glycemic carbohydrate from among the natural whole foods like potatoes, sweet potatoes, rice, oats, or something like that. If you can't do that, then you want to try to find a time where you can take tryptophan either on an empty stomach or away from at least away from other dietary protein so that you can get those tryptophan levels into the brain. Even still, once the tryptophan is in the brain, there's a lot of other things that need to happen to it that depend on many other things in your diet. The first thing that you need is antioxidant support. And that's because the first step on the way from tryptophan to melatonin is very vulnerable to oxidative stress, which is a general term that we use for wear and tear on the body that's caused by just general metabolism that increases with age or with disease states and increases with exposure to toxins like heavy metals, cigarette smoke, and alcohol. And to get antioxidant support is actually a very big topic. It means getting enough protein. It means getting enough minerals. It means getting enough vitamin C and vitamin E. And it means getting enough of the compounds found in fruits and vegetables that everyone is always raving about when they're talking about why you should get your 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables a day. That's such a big topic that I'll link in the description of this episode to a whole class that I did on the antioxidant system. And I'll also point out that in testing nutritional status of the ultimate cheat sheet, I have a whole section on how to test for and manage oxidative stress and all the nutrients involved in oxidative stress. So if you want a copy of that and you don't have one yet, you can go to chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet and you can enter the code LITE5, L-I-T-E-5, all capitals, L-I-T-E-5 for $5 off. Okay, so antioxidant support is number one. Number two is you need vitamin B6. Now, vitamin B6, like all other B or like most other B vitamins, very high in liver, very high in nutritional yeast. Generally across the board, vitamin B6 is higher in animal products than plant products. In plant products, the form of vitamin B6 is harder to absorb, and it's harder, and it has to be converted in your liver to the active form using vitamin B2. And so if you don't have a healthy liver or you don't have enough vitamin B2, you might not get the full value of the vitamin B6 from plant products. So generally having animal products in the diet is very good for your vitamin B6 status. One exception to that rule is that bananas are a great source of B6 because for several reasons. One is that the form of B6 in bananas is actually absorbed very well. Bananas are pretty high in B6. And then finally, bananas are easy to eat raw. And whether you're talking about plant foods or animal foods, cooking hurts B6 value of foods. So if you're looking up your B6 in an app like Chronometer and you think you're getting enough, you better be getting 50% more than what you think you need, unless you're eating an all-raw diet, because every time you cook your foods, you're knocking off about 40% of the B6 value of those foods. The third thing that you need is vitamin B5. You can get vitamin B5 or pantothenic acid from liver, from lean proteins, from legumes and whole grains. Then the fourth thing that needs to happen is you need to have your energy metabolism working properly. That might especially be an issue if you have problems with insulin or thyroid disorders. And then the final thing that has to happen is darkness-mediated methylation. By darkness, I mean you need 2 to 4 hours of low exposure to blue light. That's the whole basis for blue blocking, whether you're talking about night shift on your iPhone or you're talking about flux or iris on your computer, or you're talking about getting blue blocking glasses, or you're talking about getting special light bulbs that have warmer light at night like I do. That's what we mean by darkness. And by methylation, we're talking about nutrients like folate, B12, and choline. For a complete guide to managing methylation, I'll link in the description to my page, Start Here for Methylation, at chrismasterjohnphd.com/methylation. In order to give the darkness value at night, you have to get light in the morning. It's not about getting light all day. It's about starting off your day with 30 minutes or maybe even an hour of exposure to natural sunlight. So when you're thinking about why do I need to take melatonin to help me sleep? How do I fix my natural melatonin rhythm? Then we're looking at these things. Get the tryptophan into the brain, supply the nutrients that are needed, and get your light rhythm on track. This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Grass-Fed Beef Brain. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, bone marrow, brain, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.